da auch cool. Now it's over for me and it's over for you. Let's go, go, baby, it's all gone. There's no one on the corner and there's no one at home. Well, it was cool, cool, it was just all cool. Now it's over for me and it's over for you.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Stretch my hands out to the sky. TV, sunset done changed. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly. Yeah, now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you quit winning, put your lighters to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with it, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eye. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please take your seats? The pinning ceremony will begin in 5 minutes.
Let's see how far we've come. Let's see how
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remain standing until after the national anthem.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. Julie Ortega. I'm the director of the Associate Degree Nursing Program at Navarro College. We are delighted that each of you could be here for this wonderful celebration. I would like to introduce you to Heidi Andrews, who will be leading us in the invocation. And then please remain standing for our national anthem.
Good evening. Let's bow our heads and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we thank you today for being here with us on this momentous occasion. Father, we thank you, God, for being with us and guiding us through this journey, for blessing us with wonderful faculty and family and friends, our spouses, our children. Lord, for listening to us when we cried, when we laughed, in the good times and the challenging times. Father, I pray a special blessing, Lord, over these graduates. I ask, Father, that you would guide their footsteps, and I pray, Father, that you would help them to be your hands and your feet out in the field. Lord, I pray a special blessing, Lord, over the faculty and the school and over the future graduates as well. Lord, we thank you and we give you praise and glory forever. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Heidi. You may be seated. Good evening and welcome. My name is Guy Featherston, and I am the Dean of Health Professions at Navarro College. It is my pleasure to welcome you to the 2022 Navarro College Associate Degree Nursing Pinning Ceremony. This is an exciting day for all of us, administration, faculty, and staff, and most importantly, our graduates and their families. The pinning ceremony has a rich tradition in higher education. The pinning ceremony recognizes achievement, perseverance, and tenacity, and it honors the graduates for their desire to become educated and informed citizens. As such, our graduates are well prepared to meet the challenges we face in society and see these challenges as opportunity. May I extend my best wishes to you as you continue to embark on your career as registered nurses. May your achievements today guide each of you in your journey through lifelong learning and a successful career. It is now my pleasure to introduce our full-time faculty members. If you will hold your applause, please, till we introduce all the faculty members. On the platform to my right, your left, we have Marcia Cacho, Kayla DeMoss, Heather Hall, Lindsay Barrick, Samantha Capehart, and Julie Ortega. On the front row, we have Christina Thompson, Kathy Roselle, DeAndrea Price, Kathy Van Zandt, Lisa Lindsay, Sigrid Jones, and Theola Randall. Would you please now welcome to the podium Marcia Cacho and Kayla DeMoss, who will present this year's Bulldog Award recipients.
A bulldog is sociable and sweet, but with a reputation for courage. A bulldog is friendly and easygoing. A bulldog gets along with everyone.
A bulldog is someone who's tough, tenacious, and gets things done, especially in the face of adversity. A bulldog doesn't give up easily. Stick-to-itiveness is in this person's psyche.
This year's Bulldog recipient for the Waxahachie campus is Ambria Shipman.
And this year's Bulldog recipient from the Corsicana campus is Yvonne Brook. Heather Hall and I will now present the Spirit of Nursing Award.
The spirit of nursing can best be described as enthusiasm and energy that motivates one to be the best nurse they can possibly be. The students nominated for this award have demonstrated leadership, integrity, compassion, professionalism, and advocacy throughout our program. They have excelled in the classroom and clinical setting, all while working as healthcare professionals during a pandemic. That is no easy feat. They have encouraged their classmates and made a lasting impression on our faculty. Tonight, we are proud to honor this year's Spirit of Nursing recipient for the Waxahachie and Corsicana campus. For the Waxahachie campus, we are proud to honor Ms. Maggie Dragoo.
And the Spirit of Nursing Award for the Corsicana campus is awarded to Gabby Lewis. And now Lindsay Barrick.
Good evening. I have the honor of presenting our 2022 Outstanding Alumni Award. This award is designated to honor a former graduate of our program that has demonstrated commitment to our profession and the patients and community that they serve. These alumni have taken what they learned as a Navarro Bulldog and built a career. They remain committed to lifelong learning and growing within that career and work hard to do their part in making the world around them a better place. This year's recipient was a member of the Navarro ADN class of 2003. When asked what led her to nursing, she stated she wasn't one of those kids that knew she always wanted to be a nurse. She actually said she kind of stumbled into nursing. She started her educational journey pre-law. However, she wanted to help people, and that led her to Navarro College and the ADN program. She applied 2 hours before the deadline. After graduating from Navarro College, she eventually found her place at Navarro Regional Hospital Emergency Room. She served the community well as an ER nurse, but then, in her words, stumbled again into school once more. In 2012, she graduated from Texas A&M Corpus Christi with a Master's of Science in Nursing and has been practicing as a family nurse practitioner since. She has worked in several areas in different places. However, once again, she has found her way back home at Navarro Regional Hospital ER. Over her years as a nurse, she has helped many patients and families. This has never been truer than the last few years. As most healthcare fields, the years since COVID-19 have been a challenge for nursing. However, she has shown strength and continued compassion for her patients and their families. She has worked to help improve the care and outcomes of those she cares for, and she has selflessly given to her community during this trying time of learning and growing. As a child, she may not have dreamed of being a nurse, but in her years of nursing, she has proven she was born with a nurse's heart. Her passion to help others and her unbelievable dedication make her the perfect recipient of this award. Please join me in honoring our 2022 Outstanding Alumni, Ms. Joey Flores.
Thank you.
And now, Ms. Samantha Capehart. It is my privilege this evening to introduce to you the valedictorians for the 2022 graduating class. The valedictorian is the student with the highest GPA of the class. In our program, we bestow two honors. Our first honor is for the student who enters our two-year program with no prior nursing experience. This year's honoree is Misty Larson.
Well, guys, we did it. I was told to go slow. I'm not sure I can start at all, though. After the last two semesters, I really didn't think I would be up here to represent our class, but here I am. A couple of weeks ago, I was discussing graduation speeches with one of the most entertaining classmates that we have, and he said that it would probably be someone boring that would have wanted to tell everyone thank you. So, Jared, I hope I do not disappoint you or bore you as I deliver four thank yous. First, I want to thank God for his faithfulness. Without his incredible grace, I would never have started nor finished nursing school. Secondly, I want to thank our amazing instructors for all they have poured into us, but mostly for putting up with us. We have asked so many great questions. We have challenged absolutely everything, and we have complained way too much. And with the risk of receiving yet another SSI, I wish to go off script for a moment and extend a special thank you to Mrs. Barrick, who left us with our favorite piece of professional advice. Guys, when you go out for drinks, always remember to remove your shirts. And on behalf of my classmates, I would like to recognize two of our instructors who are not able to be here tonight, Nurse Mike and Nurse Sarah, who without their dedication, many of my classmates would not be graduating. The third thank you goes out to our families. I do not have enough time in my short speech to thank you enough. So suffice it to say, thank you for all those times that you have been there for us. But also, thank you for all those times that you were not when we needed to study. Finally, I want to thank my classmates. When I first started nursing school, I found out there would be 6 to 8 credits a semester, and I thought, hey, that's part-time. I can easily do that with 6 kids and a husband in school. I had no idea what a nightmare the next 2 years would be. We have diagnosed ourselves with every anxiety disorder that we have studied. Sometimes we have thought we should be the ones at tarot. At one point, I had a girl diagnosed with schizophrenia, and she sat down beside me and she leaned over and she said, "Are you okay? What is wrong with you?" I have asked myself that same question on many occasions. But through it all, you, my classmates, have been there for me. During an especially difficult week, our first semester, Gonzo said, "We are all in this together. It is no longer a competition. We are going to make it to the end if I have to drag your bloody bodies across the stage." I believe that his words set the tone that would define our class. After every exam, we would meet in the parking lot and discuss our grades. We would celebrate with those who had passed, and sometimes we would cry with those who did not. But it was never out of a spirit of pride or shame or comparison. We were just so excited that as a class, we were passing. We had each other's backs and we were there for each other. We have studied together, we have learned together. We have taught each other valuable lessons, such as how not to perform CPR. Thanks, Danny. We have helped each other, sometimes way too much. Again, thanks, Danny. We have cried together. We have laughed together. Mostly, we have complained together. Nursing school has been exhausting, but you, my classmates,
have made it bearable, and sometimes even enjoyable. I am proud of each of you, and I am proud of us as a team. While I'm relieved to be done with school, I am going to miss each of you dearly. I love you guys. The second award is for a bridge student who enters our program as a licensed vocational nurse. This year's honoree completed her LVN program here at Nevada College in 2006 and came back to further her education and finished at the top of her class. Your 2022 bridge honoree is Stacy Driscoll.
That's right, y'all. 2006. I mean, I don't think it was that long ago, but I ain't gonna lie, it was a while ago. A lot of y'all were probably still in elementary school, but man, I can't believe, I mean, this year, I know the traditionals, y'all were 2 years, but man, we had a full year, and that was long enough. That was, whew, but we made it, and that's all that matters. We made it here. I just want to say it's an honor to be the one to represent the ADN, the bridge cohort today. With everything stacked against us in the beginning, it was a you know, really dim light at the end of the tunnel, and I have to say it's shining bright today. I do want to take a minute just to say thank you to all the faculty and staff that helped us along the way. Just thank you, you know, for all of your positivity, the eagerness for us to learn, and the listening to all of our wants, needs, and complaints over and over and over again. And just like having the spritzer today and stuff, that's amazing. Like, make your skin look beautiful on the light. Just thank you for helping us to use our, you know, knowledge and skills in the clinical setting, and like not to hover over us with the fine magnifying glass, and allowing, you know, actually letting us do the things we're meant to do. And at the end of the season, or at the end of the, you know, year, when we're finally here, y'all are burnt out as much as we are, and are tired of seeing our faces as much as we're tired of seeing y'all. But we still smile, and we made it through till the end, and everyone passed. I do want to take a minute just to say thank you, just for our families and support people in the room. We really couldn't have made it through this year without y'all. Just thank you for putting up with us over this past year. I know we're a lot. We think we're a lot to each other, but I can only imagine how it is to be the other person and family. Just the long hours and not available for the special occasions, or able to be the plus ones, or just not physically capable of taking care of kids on a full-time basis. I just want to say thank y'all. You know, we couldn't have made it through this journey without y'all. Nursing school is probably one of the hardest chapters in our lives. And for those who walk beside us, I just want to give you a big thank you. Lastly, I would really like to say thank you to our kids. And hopefully from now on, we'll do our best no longer to lock ourselves in the bathrooms or pretend like we didn't hear our names when y'all called, and try to be there over the next forthcoming years, since we weren't really much there this past year. But once again, not making any promises. I mean, we're all gonna lock ourselves in the bathroom away from our kids. I mean, let's be real. Thank you just for helping us achieve our lifelong goal of you know, helping others. For my traditional graduates, I just want to give you a little forewarning, a little advice for your now future, or well now, I mean, starting tomorrow, today. When you start getting those messages that come through of the odd-shaped moles and funky-looking rashes, or somebody needing a quick diagnosis, you'll get them, but you'll start getting the messages rolling in. Not only will you get those phone calls, but you'll get the ones of people who want you to come look at your dogs, or, you know, to, like, we're vets. We apparently know all. We have our doctorates, apparently. But it was a little, you know, meshing in with you guys, you know, in the very beginning. And there were, we kind of had our traditional side and our bridge side. And towards the end, everybody kind of meshed, I thought, pretty well. We did pretty well. But we love y'all guys. Everybody, I think we finished. To my fellow bridge grads, we need to learn to remember to remove that Elvian from behind our name and place that RN back there. And that's going to be a hard habit to break. But I'm extremely proud to put that initials behind our names. We deserved every minute of it. We've worked through the trenches, pushed through, and we made it to that magnificent light at the end of the tunnel. Congratulations, class of 2022. We're now RNs.
Please join me in welcoming to the podium the District President of Navarro College, Dr. Kevin Fagan.
Thank you, Dr. Ortega, and good evening, everyone. On behalf of our Navarro College trustees and the chairman of our Board of Trustees who's with us this evening, would you please join me in greeting him, Mr. Phil Judson? The Secretary Treasurer, please join me in greeting him, Mr. Richard Aldama. Trustee, please join me in greeting her, Ms. Faith Holt. And trustee, please join me in greeting him, Mr. Buster Atkinson. Our Vice President of Academic Affairs, please join me in greeting her, Dr. Carol Haynes. The First Lady of Navarro College, please join me in greeting her, Ms. Liz Fagan. Our outstanding faculty and staff throughout our entire Navarro College district, and most importantly, our Navarro College alumni and students, we collectively congratulate you, our ADN students, soon to be ADN graduates, on your academic journey and accomplishments with Navarro College. I want to take this opportunity to thank our ADN faculty, staff, and administration for their outstanding professionalism, dedication, and ability to adapt and change during the duration of our ADN program. As you heard from our two speakers, they have had many opportunities during the pursuit of their program, unlike any class has dealt with before. And our faculty, staff, and administration has ensured that they are fully prepared to enter their career. ADN students, would you please stand and join me in thanking your faculty, staff, and ADN administration. Also, students, I want to provide you with an opportunity to thank your family, your friends, those individuals who have been there for you at different times during your pursuit with support, comfort, and the necessary things that you needed to succeed in the program. Students, here's your opportunity to thank your family and friends. You can be seated again. We are in the final 2 weeks of celebrating our 75th anniversary at Navarro College. And we have had an opportunity during this academic year to look back at a number of significant events that have helped to create, shape, and define the first 75 years of Navarro College's history, tradition, legacy, and values. And while there's been a great deal of diversity among those events, there has been one commonality among all of those. And that has been, Navarro College has been blessed with extraordinary individuals who have led those significant events that have helped to create, shape, and define our first 75 years. And there's been no group of individuals more extraordinary to Navarro College than our ADN faculty, staff, administration, and more importantly, alumni and students. These individuals have prepared themselves to change their life by preparing for a career. And in doing so, they have made the lives of others more productive, and in some cases, have saved lives that have had allowed individuals opportunities that they otherwise would not have had. So for you, our ADN students, I want you to remember the following. You now represent 75 years of Navarro College history, tradition, legacy, and values. And more specifically, you represent the Navarro College ADN program. And as you enter your careers in the next few days or weeks and continue to pursue your personal and professional goals, remember to always do so with a great deal of Bulldog pride. Again, on behalf of the entire Bulldog family, congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Fagan. At this time, we will proceed with the pinning of each graduate. As each graduate's name is called, we would like to invite their family and friends to stand in their honor. Would the first row of students please stand and come forward to receive your pins?
Heidi Andrews. Misty Larson. Stacy Driscoll. Caleb Adley. Cheyenne Anderson. Roxana Arellano Martinez. Danny Michelle Barker. Marla Becerra. Bailey Blackwood. Sarah Blank. Charlotte Bledsoe. Carrie Bodie. Esther Bravo. Simone Bridges. Colby Brindley. Yvonne Brook. Kayla Brown. Camilla Brunick. Mary Bullock. Sheila Clark. Ashley Renee Covarrubias. Claire Dixon. Maggie Dragoo. Andrea Elder. Sonica Michelle Felder. Adrian Elizabeth Franklin. Megan Freimeyer. Jessica Gomez. Maria Gomez. Jason Gonzalez. Emily Gray. Jared Hamilton. Mariah Lynn Hull. Manar Issa. Stacy Jackson. Hope Kunzman. Amber Ann Lehrman. Gabrielle Lewis. Megan Lopez. Nancy Loyola. Sharon Matthew. Crystal Medina. Brittany Meeks. Brandy Morris. Emily Mortimer. Brianna Newsom Lopez. Yvonne Avondo. Alexia Marfetta Pearson. Farron Michelle Rogers. Ambria Shipman. Christina Smith. Shelby Lynn Tennant. Sarah Underwood. Paige Watson. Brianna Weathers. Samantha White. Deja Williams. Michael Williams. Charles Wofford. Veronica Zedlar.
Will the graduates please stand? Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2022. Graduates. Graduates, please stay standing and join me in reciting the Florence Nightingale Pledge, which is printed on the back of your program. I also encourage any licensed nurse in the audience to stand and join us in reciting this pledge. And by the way, Happy Nurses Week. See any of our nurses in the building? Thank you for all that you do. Okay, let's recite the pledge. I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to faithfully practice my profession of nursing. I will do all in my power to maintain the highest nursing standards and practices. I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping in the practice of my calling. I will devote myself to the welfare of my patients, families, and community. I will endeavor to fulfill my rights and privileges as a good citizen and to take my share of responsibility in promoting the health and welfare of my community. I will constantly endeavor to increase my knowledge and skills in nursing and to use them wisely. I will zealously seek to nurse those who are in need wherever they may be. Please be seated. I will now ask for Dean Featherston to provide our closing remarks.
Thank you, Dr. Ortega.
Well, congratulations, graduates. We are so very happy for you and so very proud of you.
As I listened to some of your speakers this evening, your student representative speakers for valedictorians, they talked about the experience that all of you had. That's an experience that is unique to you because every class is different, every year is different, every person's experiences are different. But you have that shared history of having gone through, and I'm happy to report, survived nursing school. I told some of you 2 years ago, I told some of you 1 year ago that it was going to be a challenge, that it was going to take 100% of your time, effort, energies, and motivations to succeed, but that the faculty would give 100% of their time, efforts, energy, and experience to help you succeed, and here we are tonight celebrating this momentous occasion. I want to remind you, graduates, that this is not the end of your educational experience or your educational endeavors. You are going into the world of professional nursing. The world that you're experiencing today, the world that you have experienced in the last year or 2 years at Nevada College, the skills, the techniques that you have learned by the time you get to my age, will be antiquated and outdated. You are entering a profession that continues to evolve and continues to change. So whether you choose to pursue formal education through baccalaureate degrees, master's degrees, doctor's degrees, your world will continue to revolve around being an educated and up-to-date nurse. So this is just one juncture in the destination of lifelong nursing. The last thing I want to share with you is, as I had the opportunity to talk with each one of you as you came across the stage, and I know you probably share some of the same things with Dr. Fagan, I don't know what he asked, but my guess would be the same thing I asked, well, where are you going from here? And I heard things like Navarro Regional Hospital, Ennis Regional Hospital, East Texas Medical in Fairfield, Baylor, Waxahachie, Methodist Midlothian, Methodist Mansfield, Big Baylor, Corrections, Hospice, Dialysis. Some of you are looking for that opportunity that's next online. What I was most excited to hear is that none of you said, I'm not going to pursue a nursing career. I'm glad we put in that year or 2 years and you're still ready to pursue that dream. You will be outstanding nurses. I would be honored to have any one of you be my nurse when I need nursing care because I know the quality of experience you had here at the nursing program at Nevada College. In just a few days, you're going to be graduate nurses, because Ms. Ortega is going to certify that document. And then you're going to set for your licensure exam, and you will pass your examination, and you will be registered nurses. The pin that we gave you, the pin that was placed upon your chest, is a representation of your experience here at Nevada College. And everywhere you go, remember who you represent, not just yourself, not just Nevada College, but the profession of professional nursing. And you do those things and you will be successful in all of your endeavors. We thank you for letting us be a part of your educational journey, and we want to assist you in any way we can as you continue those educational pursuits. Family and friends that are here tonight, and family and friends that are watching us at home on the World Wide Web, thank you for supporting these students tonight. Thank you for the sacrifices that you made to assist them, to help them pursue and achieve their educational desires. And at tonight's conclusion, I give them back to you. So now your time is their time, as opposed to their time is our time. As we close out tonight's recessional, the stage party will exit first, led by Dr. Fagan and the Board of Trustees, followed by the faculty and the graduates. Audience, You're all invited to immediately after the recessional to join your graduate outside for the opportunity to take photos by the campus clock tower. We ask, though, please, that all of our guests, the students and the faculty, we will exit through those doors right there. We ask that all of our guests please exit through the main exits on the upper stairwell. We have to kind of protect the integrity of the stadium down here for future events that we've got coming up. So, will you all please stand with the recessional music and remain standing until all graduates have exited? Thank you.
Still, I'm learning to fly.